So, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Andrea De Bernardis. I'm in charge of the automotive components activities in Anfia. Today we have a workshop dedicated to Tunisia, the automotive sector in Tunisia, situation and prospects. Thanks to FIPA, that is the Invest in Tunisia is the agency for investment opportunities in the country. Today, we have this webinar that will be organized in two sections, as you can see in the agenda. The first, with an overview on investment opportunities in the country and the form of cooperation. Then we will have a speech from the representative of the Tunisian Automotive Association that he will give us a focus on the automotive sector. After the opening speech, that will be managed from the ambassador and Mr. Decisi, that is the vice president of the Anfia Components Group, FIPA will show a short video regarding the automotive sector. In the second section, some case histories with four companies that will share their experience with us. We will close the event with a Q&A session. So if someone is interested in putting some questions regarding the topics that will be part of the discussion today, they can use the chat that is on the right side of your video. And then we will manage this question during the session. In any case, FIPA will be available in the next weeks for all the companies that would like to evaluate or open an activity in the country from an industrial or commercial point of view. So now we can start with an opening speech from the ambassador, Mr. Moez Sinaoui. He will do his speech in Italian for hospitality reason, due to the fact that the attendees are in part Italian and in part Tunisian people. And so I leave the floor to the ambassador. Thank you.
Grazie, grazie. Buongiorno a tutti. Sono veramente molto onorato di aprire questa bellissima riunione, anche se con webinar a distanza, ma è sempre un piacere. Io vorrei ricordare innanzitutto che questo evento capita 4 anni, quasi giorno per giorno, dopo un Tunisian Automotive Day che ho aperto anche a Torino, a Mirafiori, nel Fiat Village a Torino, dove erano presenti tutti i leader del settore automotive in Tunisia. Hanno fatto una presentazione, hanno fatto anche una presentazione dei loro prodotti. E dunque 4 anni, giorno per giorno, quasi, era il 17 maggio a Mirafiori. Fortunatamente stiamo facendo la ripresa dei contatti a livello economico, a livello di cooperazione tra la Tunisia e l'Italia, e io sono molto felice perché questa ripresa si fa con settore automotive che è sempre stato una locomotiva, fa da treno a tutti gli scambi fra la Tunisia e l'Italia. Vogliamo approfondire, rafforzare, andare avanti, anche se sia in Italia la situazione economica oggi non è al meglio, ma passando di questa situazione, da questo punto zero, abbiamo tutte le porte aperte. L'Italia sta facendo un piano di ripresa, sta lanciando un piano di ripresa con l'Europa, un recovery fund, molto, un recovery plan molto importante. Anche la Tunisia sta preparando un piano di rilancio molto ambizioso con il Fondo Monetario Internazionale e la Banca Mondiale, e dunque anche la Tunisia e sulle starting block per una ripresa, per una bella ripresa dopo questa parentesi di pandemia che speriamo tutto sarà chiusa fra qualche settimana o al massimo qualche mese. E dunque siamo tutti qua. Ringrazio veramente l'Anfia, la FIPA per questa iniziativa. L'Antia, che da oltre un secolo di attività è oramai un punto di riferimento nel settore automotive in Italia. Ringrazio anche l'Associazione Tunisina di Automotive, ringrazio tutti e mi auguro di una bella riunione tra partner tunisini e italiani. E, come ho detto, è questa la prima riunione di rilancio e spero, mi auguro che il settore automotive sarà, ripeto ancora di più, la locomotiva di una ripresa intensiva dei rapporti economici fra la Tunisia e l'Italia. Grazie a tutti e buon lavoro.
Thank you, Ambassador, for your speech. Before leaving the floor to Pierangelo Decisi, that is the Vice President of the Automotive Components in ANFIA, just I remind you that, as explained the Ambassador, we are the Italian association that represents in Italy the whole automotive sector. We have more than 370 members, manufacturers of vehicles, suppliers, that means producer of module system and single components, and companies that are active in the services of design and engineering. Many of the participants are already ANFIA members. I hope also that other Italian companies that today are our guest could evaluate in the future to enter into the association, and we are fully available for this type of opportunity. Now I leave the floor, as I explained, to Pierangelo Decisi, that is the Vice President of the Automotive Component Sector, that would like to give a message to all the people attending. Thank you. Sorry, Pierangelo, we can't hear the audio. Please. Okay. Right now it is okay.
Thank you very much, Andrea. First of all, good morning, all of you, and Ramadan Karim on late, but I think that it's appreciated. ANFIA is the automotive association of Italian industry and represents this business, this important business, the first industrial business in Italy, represent this in front of the of the parliament. So, we want to explain you our internalization sector. So inside ANFIA there are a team of people. I represent the, I'm in charge to drive this, to lead this, this team of the internationalization. Internationalization is mean to have a relation with other countries in which we could find the opportunity to invest or to attract the investments. For that, we organize a country workshop, face-to-face business, or special project framework. So it means that if a group of people wants to know better our industry market, or our companies wants to improve the relation with a specific country, our job is to mix, to follow, to support this kind of relation. So what is mean? It means that welcome to the company of from Tunisia who wants to have relation or invest in Italy, and welcome to the Italian industry that wants to have much more relation with Tunisia or invest in Tunisia. As the ambassador said before, we are living in an extraordinary moment. So a lot of things will change. Sure, we don't know really in which kind of way, but sure, some things will change. So what is mean in the industry, this changement. Sure, the business will have some evolution in the future in terms of social responsibility, in terms of ecology, in terms of new technology. So our job, like entrepreneur, like people who lead company, is to find the product and the service of the future. The business will change, sure, and the opportunity are really big to show idea, proposal, new service, new products in both country and in all the world. So I'm happy to open with the ambassador this conference, but take care that the goal is to increase new vision of business. For that, we have to push together the governments of both country to continue to improve the acceptance of the industry in their country. We are living in a moment in which will be a lot of money, but this money has to be spent in the proper way. And Tunisia could be a good partner of that, in which develop new products, new service for not only the Italian industry, but minimum the European industry. About the globalization, we doesn't know very well what's happening in the future, but sure, in the future will be a renewable concept of regionalization. So regionalization is meant to speak about Europe and North Africa together, Morocco, Tunisia, Algeria, South, North Europe. So it's a big market, is a good opportunity to establish new kind of products. For example, semiconductor. You know that in this moment, we have a big problem in the shortage of semiconductor and electronic components. So we have to imagine a new idea of business, a new idea of country in which we have to invest or export, and sure something will change. We have to drive. We have to drive this change. And so for that, it's important to speak together, to have relation, to manage and share idea in order to find the best products and the best service for the customer for the future. So could be a good opportunity, taking in consideration this, to improve and to grow the relation between these two marvelous countries. Thank you very much.
So thank you, Pierangelo, for your recommendation. Before leaving the floor to Mr. Abdel Basset Nami, that is the General Manager of the Invest in Tunisia Agency, FIPA has the pleasure to show you a short video regarding the country. So please. Thank you. Thank you for the video. And now, Mr. Gnami, if you want to present the investment framework and opportunities in Tunisia, please, it's your turn.
Thank you, Mr. Andrea. Very good morning to all of you. First of all, I would like to thank His Excellency, the Ambassador, for his availability. I would like also to thank ANFIA, the Tunisia Automotive Association, and special thanks for the representatives of companies which will share their experience with us today. I would like to thank all the participants from Italy and from Tunisia to this important webinar. And His Excellency mentioned that the first event has been organized, I think, 3 years or 4 years ago. And we believe that it's a good time, it's the right time now to resume our cooperation with the Italian companies, in particular in the automotive component sector, which is one of the main sectors of our cooperation. I will try to share with you my presentation. So the presentation will mainly, I will be focusing mainly on the assets of Tunisia as an attractive business destination. But first, I will give you an overview of the FDI in Tunisia and to show that Tunisia, despite the current difficult situation linked to the COVID context, Tunisia is still an attractive business destination. It is home to over 3,600 companies, providing jobs to more than 400,000. Almost 75% of foreign companies are wholly exporting, so it's mainly for the export. And also to show that the evolution of the, first of all, there is a substantial investment in the manufacturing industry, as its share exceeds 55%. And the evolution of the FDI in Tunisia is mainly driven by substantial investment in the electronic, and in particular in the automotive industry. So the automotive industry is really a leading industry in Tunisia. And there are trends in high added value activities, in particular with electric and connected cars, and I believe that Mr. Nabhan will provide more details in this regard. Regarding the cooperation and with Italy, Italy is one of the main investors, foreign investors in Tunisia. We have over 900 Italian companies working in Tunisia in different sectors, from textile to the digital sector, and through the automotive, where we have several Italian companies which are really developing their activities. Here you have an example of foreign companies that have chosen Tunisia as a production site. And some of them are, of course, Italian brands. So why Tunisia is an attractive business destination? First, the main asset of Tunisia is its human resource. So Tunisia has invested a lot in education and continue to invest more and more in training. So we have over 60,000 new graduates per year. There is a trend and in the engineering and ICT fields, which now represents 80% of graduates. And also the country is ranked second in the world in terms of graduates in science and engineering. So it's very important to emphasize that the human resource and the skills of Tunisia is very important. So we have the right skills. It's very important for foreign companies. It's challenging for the Tunisian government because we have a high level of unemployment rate. The average now within the pandemic is over 17%, but in some within graduates, it exceeds 30%. So it's an opportunity for international companies to find the right skills in Tunisia in different fields. So Tunisia is indeed a confirmed expertise. So Tunisia is ranked first in North Africa in terms of general expertise, according to the Global Competitive Index. We have a strong R&D activities, and we are very happy to see that many automotive components, including Italian, are investing more in addition to the production. They are investing more in the R&D activities. There is a strong capacity of innovation in Tunisia. We are ranked third as an innovative economy in Africa. So we have a leading position in Africa, and we are first in North Africa. And the availability of a large pool of graduates, as I mentioned, in particular in the automotive industry. And there is a strong presence of engineers and technicians in this field. And also the availability of manager skills. Most of foreign companies in Tunisia, they are managed by Tunisians. We are proud to say that we have the right skills at all levels. So most of foreign companies, they are managed by 100% by Tunisians. And even we have Tunisians which are managing international companies abroad, such as in Morocco and in other sites. In addition to, so Tunisia is able to provide the right skills. So there is a strong availability of skills and also at competitive price. So first of all, we ensure foreign companies that we can provide the right skills. And also Tunisia is one of the most competitive in terms of cost of skills. And this is according to the FDI benchmark tool, which is label of Financial Times that we are using to provide the right information to international companies to enable them to see how Tunisia is competitive compared to other countries, either in the region, in North Africa, in the Mediterranean, or compared to our destinations such as the eastern and central part of Europe or even Asia. So you have an indication about the cost of an engineer, and as you can see, compared to Macedonia, Romania, Morocco, or the Czech Republic, we are very well positioned at all level of the skills, from engineering to production operative skills, and also for the production assembler. The second asset of Tunisia, of course, is the infrastructure, which, of course, we have the right infrastructure which enable foreign companies to produce and to export in good condition, and also to enable them to have their inputs and also all the export of the finished products. So we have several industrial lands which are, and we have clusters for the automotive components industries. And for other sectors, we have also some techno parks, which are really the right to provide the right facilities in terms of the availability of all the infrastructure and the quality services, and also all the availability of other facilities such as ports, which will be improved, and hopefully in the near future we will launch good program to upgrade our infrastructure, in particular related to logistics, to the sea deep water, which is a good project for Tunisia. The third asset is our geographic position. And Tunisia is well positioned to, which enable foreign companies to produce in Tunisia and to export to potential markets north to Africa, to Europe, and to neighboring countries, and south to Africa. So we are less than 1 hour from Europe, from Italy, indeed, and less than 20 hours from by sea to neighboring seaports, in particular Genova in Italy and Marseille in France. We have several free trade agreements, one with Europe, one with several others are with neighboring countries. And also we are enhancing our integration into Africa by joining different parts of Africa, because we have historical links with sub-Saharan African countries, and now we are joining big groups, in particular in the southern and the, in the western part of Africa, by joining COMESA and also the western part of Africa, ECOWAS. And also we have several international and regional integration agreements with more than 50 agreements are already available now. The other asset, of course, is the friendly business environment. So we have long history and strong history with foreign direct investment. We start by attracting foreign investment in the early 70s with textile, then we move to high added value activity in the electrical, electronic and the automotive industry. So first of all, the guarantee of foreign investment. So investment is free in Tunisia in major sectors. So you can invest freely without any authorization, in particular in the manufacturing, in the services related to industry and to and all the service, the exporting service activities. There is no restriction to for the transfer of profits and capital gains, and also simplified procedures. And we are working to enhance the and to simplify more the by digitalizing all the investment process, and also the ease of import and export, and everything is done on site. So the customs clearance is done on site. And also the we are providing we have more than 18 activities which are considered as priority sector, including the automotive industry, and they are entitled to several financial and fiscal incentives. Substantial incentives are granted to these activities, 15% as a priority sector, and up to 30% of the investment amount for exporting activities, and also for investment made in regional development zones. And also the exemption from income tax up from 5 to 10 years, and the assumption of a social contribution for up to 10 years. This shows that it's foreign investment is a priority for Tunisia, and we are working to improve the business climate in Tunisia and to provide the right service to foreign investors in Tunisia. To conclude, a few words about FIPA, which is the government organization in charge of promoting foreign direct investment in Tunisia. We have an experience of 25 years, and we are we provide information on the business environment, on the incentives which are granted to foreign investors, and also the business opportunities. And we provide advice, guidance to foreign investors during all the steps of their implementation in Tunisia. And we have also an aftercare service for companies operating in Tunisia. So we consider foreign investors as partners, and as and the companies which will provide their testimonies, they are considered as partners with us, and we are working together. And I believe that our event today is good example of partnership, public private partnership, and we are ready really to work with all the stakeholders, both from the public and the private sector, both in Tunisia and Italy, with the support of course of the our embassy in Rome. We are ready really to provide you with all the information. We have our office in Milano. It's an office with more than 25 years now in Italy. And I believe that my colleague in Italy, Bilal, is ready also to provide you with the right advice. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm ready to answer your question. Thank you all.
So thank you, Mr. Adnani. So as you explained, we can see that in Tunisia there is a good level of research and development, lowest cost of labor, a geostrategic position in the Mediterranean area that could, in some of the factors that could attract also some Italian companies. Take into account also that the country has a strategic position because some other autonomous countries like Spain, France, Italy are very close to Tunisia. Now, before leaving the floor to Mr. Nabdeh Bouchallah, that is the president of the Tunisia Automotive Association, I remember to the participant that in 2018, with Pierangelo Decisi, we signed a memorandum of understanding with the association, with the Tunisian Automotive Association. And this workshop is one of the examples of cooperation between the two associations. So I leave the floor to Mr. Bouchallah. Mr. Bouchallah, sorry for the audio. There is a problem. Maybe you have to turn on your audio.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, Andrea. Good morning. Good morning. I want to share with you a presentation about the Tunisian automotive sector to give you an idea about what we are doing and what we have in Tunisia. Do you see it? Okay.
Yes, you will see. You have just only to. Okay. Now is okay.
That's now to give you an idea about. You know, we see the video, and I will give you the detail about what it was in the video presented from the FIPA. That really in Tunisia we have annually growth about 12%. We have 280 companies, well, there is 20 national companies working in the automotive industry. The automotive industry representing 4% from the GDP from the country. More than that, we have an assembly units for cars, 9 assembly units. The automotive sector, is, as Mr. Abbasid said, that is very important for the Tunisian, let's say, economy. It's 2.4 billion euro volume export on a yearly basis. And also we are more or less 42% located integration. This automotive sector, let's say, give a job for more than 90,000 people. In the auto sector overview, you can see the value chain that we are from the third tire. We have the second tire and first tire components, let's say from the material to the manufactured or basis components to the assembly of sets and models. We, for the moment, don't have OEMs, but we are producing and assembling cars. You will see part of this assembling car that we are doing in Tunisia. We distribute cars for sure, and we are maintaining cars and the maintenance and inspection and repair for the cars. How it is divided in Tunisia, we have 13 activities, those related to the electrical, and also interior, transmission, chassis, all the components for the car, more or less. And we are organized with 4 clusters, commercial vehicle clusters, interior and mobile clusters, electronic clusters, and electrical clusters. More how it is those, let's say, by segment. You can see the segment. We are in electronics. We have all electronics cards, printed circuits, display systems. Everything is more or less electronics are produced in Tunisia. Spare parts for sure, for batteries and accumulators. Textile leather, which is for cars, mechanics, over surface treatments, and also gas stamping. Electrical wiring, this is the most big one in Tunisia. We have the largest, let's say, electrical wiring companies here in Tunisia. And also design and development industrialization, software development, and also technical order, special mechanical and structures of calculation. more or less here in Tunisia, we have, let's say, plastic, rubber, or the injection molding. They are produced in Tunisia. Currently, the supply is able to reach more than 40% from local integration rate for the company. For that, we have assembly, we have Tunisian car, let's say car branded Wallis car, developed and produced in Tunisia. As we said, there is a SKD like staffing module where they are producing the pickup made in Tunisia. And the Geely and Mahindra, they are assembling units in Tunisia. This is part of design, engineering, and manufacturing assembly trades. As Mr. Buffett said, that Tunisia is a pool of talent, and there is a strong R&D activity here in Tunisia. We are people are managing, middle management are managing all the companies here in Tunisia, and also the activeness of talents. We know that a lot of talents, they write a lot in Tunisia. As we have available and large pool of graduate people, one important point is 6,300 graduates per year in discipline related to automotive. You can see that which is more or less a big part of them, more than 40% of them are engineers right from schools, Asian schools. You see that, okay, it's already defined, but you know that we are ranked in innovation and economy. There is multiple technical centers, a very big part of technical centers in Tunisia. There is technology research, center providing design, prototyping, electrical and mechanical virtual platform, a research center in nanotechnology and microelectronics. We have a technical center for chemistry, where the R&D projects in plastic, rubber, industry and connected to the laboratory testing and analysis. Technical Center for Mechanical and Electrical Industry. There is will be for prototyping, modernization also, and production of methods, organization, technical improvement of quality control, and the human resource efficiency. You can see here many of international companies have an R&D center in Tunisia, Croatia, Coffee Cup, Estonia, Netherlands, Lyon, Georgia, and more. Many of, let's say, international and local Tunisian companies, you can see in this figure that more or less almost all the companies working in the component of automotive are already installed in Tunisia. You can see Asian, international, and also Italian company already in this. For sure, as Tunisians are very, very close to Europe, and we have this position for the supply chain. A lot of, let's say, European car manufacturers like Daimler, Fiat, they are getting sourcing and major components in Tunisia. I will not leave without giving you an idea about the TAA, the Tunisian Automotive Association. The missions and objectives. You know, we in TAA, our mission is to stimulate the Tunisian automotive part industry to export, locate, located integration, and development of human capital. Also, we are actively working closely with the government to develop the automotive sector in Tunisia, mainly with the FIPA and with the industry in Tunisia. Our main priority is to represent the interest of our members and ensure effective communication with the public authority. You know, we are always here to support our, let's say, members and present what we need from government and from internal organization to support. We encourage all the initiative assets. You know, we are supporting, we are supporting all the investors where we are here with the FIPA to give the support and to give the where and support how to install an operations here in Tunisia. For sure, we are supporting also Tunisian to go further from Tunisia to other countries like Italy and for other countries overall. We develop a support of training initiative in automotive sector. We are developing now the Tunisian Automotive Management Academy. This academy to support, let's say, the know-how, knowledge, and the know of training and way of working for operators in all the fields in the automotive sector. An idea about the members, you can see we have now 69 members, and we have almost Tunisian and foreign company inside of the TAA. You know that in the TAA we are here waiting for investment, whatever the investment it's going to Tunisia. We are supporting, giving all our support and pushing with the government to go further with the companies that start to work with us and start to continue. We are supporting all our members, problems that they are facing in the difficult period. We are always here to support our members. Yeah. Thank you very much. You can see here, let's say, the links for TAA, and we're going to share the presentation with all the people in order that you see the global presentation, because it's a smaller one, to give you an idea more for things. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Guccella, and thank you also to share this presentation that could be very useful for the Italian companies. So now I'm going to give the floor to Mr. Murad Radi, that is the president of the Tunisian Italian Chamber of Commerce, that will do his speech in Italian. Please, Mr. Radi.
Okay, grazie. Grazie per l'invito e per questa occasione per un po' parlare delle relazioni fra la Tunisia e l'Italia di maniera generale. Ho visto che Monsieur Rané e Bouchala hanno parlato anche, hanno dato tantissimi dati, informazioni importanti, donc non mi hanno lasciato tantissimo spazio per fare il mio speech, l'ho cambiato rapidamente. Io voglio raggiungere un'altra informazione importante, che nel 2019-2020 l'Italia è divenuto il primo partner sugli scambi commerciali con la Tunisia, prima anche dalla Francia, e questo è anche un dato molto importante, con un volume import-export di 14 milioni di dinari, e questa è la prima volta che è venuta davanti alla Francia. Rimane la Francia sempre il primo partner sull'investimento diretto straniero, ma questo per dire che le relazioni di scambi commerciali sono divenute abbastanza importanti. L'altro punto voglio anche raggiungere sulla presentazione dei miei colleghi, che gli investimenti diretti stranieri che sono stati fatti nell'anno 2020 e 2019 particolarmente, non sono tantissimi nuovi investimenti, creazioni di società, ma sono dei progetti di estensione di società, che vuol dire che gli investitori che sono in Tunisia hanno fatto altri investimenti. Questo che vuol dire? Vuol dire che le società che sono sul sito Tunisia hanno visto le capacità delle società, della manodopera, dell'ingegnere, parlo tantissimo dell'ingegnere, e su questa base hanno creduto nel sito Tunisia e hanno fatto il loro progetto di extensione. Questa è una cosa importante, e la differenza fra di noi e altri paesi della regione, che i nostri direttori, la maggiorità degli stabilimenti in Tunisia sono tunisini, dalla scuola tunisina, e nelle altre paesi che sono concorrenti della regione prendono anche diverse volte degli ingegneri tunisini per gestire gli stabilimenti all'estero. Donc questo è un punto molto forte qui in Tunisia, e la manodopera a qualità un po' del personale di alto livello. Volevo anche darvi qualche indicazione, qualche cifra importante. Che noi Camere di Commercio abbiamo fatto un sondaggio ultimamente, e questo sondaggio con le società italiane in Tunisia di maniera generale, fra di loro diverse società nell'automotive. 43% delle imprese prevedono un aumento di giro di affari nel 2021, sul sito Tunisia. 43% anche per cento prevedono nuovi investimenti nel 2021, più di 50% di queste imprese hanno detto che non hanno avuto un impatto particolare Covid sul lavoro e non hanno abbassato il numero di persone, e 62% prevedono di prendere nuovi personale un po' sull'anno 2021. Questo per dire che le società italiane in Tunisia, una grande parte di loro si portano bene e non ha avuto un impatto molto duro un po' sul Covid. Se permettete, voglio condividere con voi qualche dati importanti sul settore automotive fra la Tunisia e l'Italia. Il primo slide, si vedete, questi sono qualche, diciamo, codici doganale.
Scusi, signor Fredi, dovrebbe soltanto metterla a figura intera. Full slide.
Okay. Non so se si vede bene, sì. Volevo dire questa tabella perché è importante, perché si vede l'importazione nel settore dell'automotive, componenti automotive, dell'Italia nel mondo. E con le codici che vedete sopra in codici doganali. Donc, l'Italia per 2020 ha importato dal mondo 13,244 miliardi di euro e la Tunisia ha esportato verso l'Italia solamente 0,229, che sono 1,73% solamente. Con tutta la prossimità geografica, con tutte un po' le relazioni, c'è ancora molto spazio a esportare verso l'Italia. E noi in Camera di Commercio possiamo anche, con gli imprenditori tunisini e anche italiani, abbiamo delle tabelle per vedere un po' quali sono tutte le possibilità per le società tunisine a esportare verso l'Italia. Questa tabella fa vedere che c'è un gap importante, che c'è ancora molto spazio a collaborare fra le due paesi. E il secondo slide sono le zone geografiche dove importa l'Italia. Come vedete, è normale anche quasi 80% delle importazioni italiane nel 2000 volte sono nelle regioni nord-ovest dell'Italia, Lombardia, Piemonte e anche un po' il Veneto, sono lì dove si esporta di più o si importa di più, e noi possiamo anche muoverci in queste regioni che chiedono tantissima componente auto. Questa era rapidamente, avevo previsto altri slide eccetera, ma visto che tantissime cose sono state dette, noi Camere di Commercio abbiamo partecipato, come ha detto prima l'ambasciatore, 4 anni fa alla riunione a Torino, e siamo veramente a disposizione di tutti i potenziali investitori, anche questioni diverse. Collaboriamo molto bene con la FIPA e con l'ambasciata tunisina a Roma. Grazie per l'attenzione.
So thank you, Mr. Fradi, and many thanks for your comments and input regarding the trade balance among the two countries that are useful as an integration, referred to the previous presentations. Now we enter into the second session of the webinar. We will present some case histories. We have 4 companies. The first one is AEC, that stands for Automotive Components, Cable and Harnesses. AEC is an Italian middle-sized company. Alberto Forcarelli, that is the speaker, is also the founder of the companies in 1986. They have 2 plants in Italy and also a presence in another countries like Romania and in Tunisia. Now I leave the floor to Alberto. Thank you.
Thank you for the invitation. Thank you and hello to all the participants. So I will try to be quick and avoid to bore anybody there. So I have a little presentation to share. Let me see. Non la vedo. Questo.
There is a button. Okay. Okay.
Okay. So, so this is as a was said, we are working, trying to work at international level. So we are delivering our parts all over the world, and we have production facility in Italy, in Romania, Tunisia, and in China. And we have development center and distribution center in Michigan, where we serve the NAFTA market, and we deliver directly from here to South America, to Brazil. Just to give you an idea of what we are doing, this is our last project that was last award, that was the Alfa Romeo Tonale, the future Alfa midsize. And on the right, you see the product that we are supplying to this car, basically all what we produce, all kind of products. So we have been able to convince the customer to adopt our product for this very important car. And I can be very proud of all the team that been working on this project, where we could achieve, let's say, 100% of our potential target. So we have data cables, antenna and camera cables, terminals, battery cables for a low voltage and high voltage, and washer hoses. For this, the antenna and camera cables and the battery cables are produced in Tunisia. So what we are doing is to work for new development and for new components that are mainly applied on the hybrid and electric vehicles and connected vehicles. It means we are following the big stream of electrification of the cars, and more they are going to use power cables, so big size from 25 to 50 or more millimeter square. And we have developed ourselves a process to replace the copper with the aluminum. And this is giving a lot of benefits to the cost and to the weight of the car, with the CO2 saving. And this kind of product has created a lot of interest from our old customer, which is of course FCA, now Stellantis, but also from the other German customer like VW, Audi and BMW. And we are now trying to face many other OEMs, which are basically all interested to this kind of technology. And then we have brought in a new production for all the need of the new interconnected cars, where we have up to 60 different cables which connect the Wi-Fi, the different antennas, and all the camera around the car. And this is also a very fast growing market. And for these two main projects, we have chosen the the plant of Tunis. So we have started the production in 2018 in Foshana, and the building on the left side is our current building, where we have about 3,000 square meters and we employ about 150 people. And we have just launched a new investment for a new plant, which will be, let's say, 20 kilometers south of Tunis in Jbel, El West. And we hope to be ready by the end of next year. And we believe we will be able in this time to employ 400 people. So for us, it is quite a success, because I decided to invest in Tunisia exactly 4 years ago, thanks to the ambassador that remembers me the date of this important meeting that you had with in Mirafiori. And in that day, I met Madame El Ghul and a partner from Coffee Cup, and they came to visit me here, and they gave me the idea to invest in Tunisia. And from that day, we basically made a couple of visits, decided to open the factory, and in June we were in mass production. And so for me, 4 years has been a long time, but honestly, I believe it was quite a nice decision and an important point for us, since we are now growing quite fast. What I want to add at last is that the growing of AEC in Tunisia correspond to a growth of AEC in Italy, both for metal stamping facility that we have in Busto Arsizio, where we produce all the components, the connectors that are used in Tunisia, but also for the R&D department and what is in the headquarter here in Torino, because we have a common development between engineering in Torino and engineering in Tunisia. And this in general is for us quite a positive reaction also for the local economy, and so we expect to be able to complete this project in the given time. So this was I hope quite briefly a picture of our company profile.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Forcarelli, also for this experience that we have shared with all the people. Now I'm leave the floor to Mr. Ani Benetili, that is a manager from Sage Automotive. Sage is a multinational company that design and manufacture innovative interiors. They have also a company in Italy. The name of the company in Italy is Apollo. Maybe in the Q&A session, Mr. Tili could help us replying to the question that put in the chat Mr. De Pasquale about some components that are part of the interiors. So I leave the floor to Mr. Tili. Sorry, Mr. Tili, for the audio, you should turn on your audio.
Good morning. I switched to language Italian. Ben Tilianis, direttore stabilimento di Sage Tunisia. Contento di partecipare con tutti voi. Un saluto particolare al dottor Fradi Murad, al dottor Paolo Mugnoli, al signor il dottor Ghanmi Abdelbaset, che conosce già la nostra storia di 2-3 anni fa, e un saluto particolare anche al dottor Pastoris. Allora, posso parlarvi di Sage Tunisia? È una realtà operativa dal 2019, è una creazione nuova di una nuova realtà in Tunisia. Con il mio investitore abbiamo deciso di crearla e installarla all'inizio del 2019. Dal settembre 19 siamo partiti con la produzione e la qualifica con i nostri clienti. Di seguito abbiamo avuto la qualifica e dal mese di ottobre 2019 siamo partiti con i primi export. Quello che ha fatto questo successo di partenza è la competenza dei miei collaboratori assunti nel corso dell'anno 2019, il primo livello di ingegnere che hanno in età giovane, da una media di 30-35 anni, 100% tunisini. E poi con questi collaboratori ci siamo riusciti a assumere della manodopera qualificata. Vi do un numero, due numeri: siamo partiti con 10 persone, oggi siamo a 350 persone come forza a Sage Tunisia. Vi faccio presentare un short presentation di Sage Tunisia. Allora, si veda?
Dovrebbe solo metto la, ecco, schermo intero, va bene adesso, prego.
Va bene. Allora, Sage Tunisia si trova nel contorno di Tunisi Centro, che fa parte di un gruppo che si trova dappertutto nel mondo. Il primo plant creato, come ho detto prima, in Tunisia in corso dell'anno 2019. Tunisia la conoscete tutti, siamo 12 milioni di popolazione, ci siamo trovati, abbiamo trovato la località a 10 minuti dall'aeroporto di Tunis Carthage, a 20 minuti dal porto di Rades. Il sito si trova su 22.000 metri quadri, di cui 13.000 metri quadri di coperto. Siamo al 50-60% di occupazione dei metri quadri coperti. Il nostro market europeo, l'organizzazione fatta con dei ingegneri come di primo livello di qualità, engineering, produzione, logistica, human resource, sono tutti, come ho detto prima, delle competenze tunisine al 100%, che sono oggi in relazione diretta con i nostri clienti, dalla qualità alla logistica all'engineering. Il sito oggi è pieno con dell'attrezzatura industriale, con delle tavole di taglio automatici, con delle macchine di cucitura, con delle macchine per l'airbag. Abbiamo un piano di investimento per andare avanti sull'anno 2022, tra 21 e 22, per passare da 350 oggi a 700 in corso dell'anno 22. Il current production, stiamo consegnando per i progetti GP Compass, G-Prenegate, Idrest appoggiatesta per la Compass e Renegade, e Opel anche come un cliente francese, come cliente fuori di dell'area Jeep e Fiat. Siamo in partenza anche con un nuovo progetto che siamo in fase di qualifica per l'Alfa Tonale, la nuova vettura dell'Alfa. Nei piani di investimenti futuri abbiamo anche in mano la mano sul Jeep Junior e l'Opel Astra e anche un'altra vettura di Skoda. Questa è una short presentation di Sage Tunisia. Parlo in due parole quello che dico che ha fatto il successo della partenza fino ai nostri clienti, che stiamo facendo la consegna al 100% delle richieste a tempo e meno di 500 ppm come qualità, zero extra costi su trasporti eccezionali. Quello che ha fatto di tutto è la scelta e la disponibilità della competenza e la manodopera qualificata. Quindi in 2 anni e mezzo siamo tranquilli con i nostri clienti, sono contenti e ci siamo anche riusciti a certificare il sito con l'IATF ultimamente. Dico ai nuovi investitori come le miei, il benvenuto in Tunisia. Dovete avere fiducia che il terreno è ancora fertile e si può andare avanti con dei nuovi progetti anche da zero, non solo di estensione o di aumenti di fatturato, ma potete anche creare della nuova realtà come la nostra. E posso dire anche sarete benvenuti da me per vedere questa realtà terreno. Grazie a tutti.
Okay, many thanks, Mr. Bentaidi, and also to have shared with us the experience of Sage Automotive. Now, Salvatore Faugiana from Cablem, that is an Italian company leader in the production of wiring harnesses for many automotive components, and they have several also customers among the OEMs. And if I'm not mistaken, they have a plant in Tunisia, in Bizerte. So please, Mr. Faugiana.
Buongiorno, grazie a tutti. Mi presento per chi non mi conosce, sono Salvatore Faugiana, sono presente in Tunisia dal 2001. La mia esperienza in Tunisia, ho gestito 4 nuovi progetti nel settore industriale e anche dei progetti di cooperazione culturale trasfrontaliera Italia-Tunisia che hanno avuto rilevanza internazionale. Dal 2018 sto coordinando lo startup della Cablem Tunisia in qualità di General Plant Manager e amministratore della stessa. La società fa parte del gruppo Cablem, non perché non mi va avanti.
Sì, adesso vediamo
Ok, perfetto. Allora, fa parte del gruppo Cablem. La Cablem è un'azienda italiana leader nella produzione di cablaggi per componenti automobilistici. L'azienda è in continua crescita ed espansione, concentrando le proprie attività produttive in un'ampia gamma di prodotti con una forte attenzione alla qualità. Cablem SPA fornisce i prodotti direttamente e indirettamente ai maggiori OEM. La fondazione della Cablem risale al 1980, il quartier generale è in Italia, a Cambiano. vicino a Torino, il gruppo ha due business unit, una dedicata alla unit electrical, cablaggi, che ha circa 1600 persone nell'insieme, con aziende produttive dislocate in Italia, Moldavia, Romania e Tunisia. E la società, invece il Business Unit Electronics, dove si fanno assemblaggi per circuiti stampati, con una forza lavoro di 115 persone, e l'azienda è in Italia, in Sicilia, a Carini. La Business Unit cablaggi è suddivisa per il 44% in lighting, il 28% condizionatori, il 20% sedili, e un po' di powertrain, 4%, e poi altre minimi. I nostri fornitori principali sono FCA, Lear, Automotive Lighting, Denso, Martur, così vedete nelle slide. Il gruppo Cablem è in continuo sviluppo e nelle unità di produzione vuole offrire ai propri clienti il vantaggio di un processo completamente integrato. Quindi è per questo motivo che nasce il Cablem nel 2018 e si è scelta la Tunisia come posto dove farla nascere. E la Cablem Tunisia è su un'area totale di 15.000 metri quadrati, di cui 8.000 sono coperti e 5.700 sono dedicati alla produzione. Ad oggi abbiamo 369 dipendenti e siamo già certificati IATF da marzo 2021. Il sito è ubicato a Mezzeggio Emile. Qui facciamo principalmente 100% nel settore di cablaggi per automotive. L'azienda presenta tutte le varie funzioni, quindi quelle dedicate alla produzione, alla qualità, all'engineering, alla logistica, alla manutenzione e quant'altro. La Cablem era, diciamo, ha un'esperienza in Tunisia risalente al 2007, con un subcontractor, quindi un terzista. Nel 2017, a seguito di una crescita del gruppo, si è deciso di creare una struttura in Tunisia dove sviluppare nuove attività e creare un nuovo stabilimento con un processo completamente integrato. Questa è la prima esperienza di processo completamente integrato per la Cablem. Nel settembre 2018 si costituisce la società, nel 19 gennaio ci consegnano il capannone. A giugno siamo partiti, dopo aver fatto tutte le installazioni necessarie, siamo partiti con la produzione. A marzo abbiamo avuto l'onore di avere già l'ISO TS 16.949. Tutto ciò è stato impattato dalla pandemia, perché lo startup è stato in una situazione un po' difficile, per causa pandemia, perché ci ha stoppato il nostro programma di crescita. Nei mesi successivi, diciamo alla pandemia, abbiamo avuto dei momenti di incertezza, non si capiva se si riprendeva, non si riprendeva, quindi non abbiamo neanche potuto iniziare lo startup in maniera, come dire, proseguire il nostro startup in maniera, come si evince anche dal grafico. E a settembre tutti i clienti sono andati a pieno regime, quindi massima richiesta da parte del cliente e massimo, giustamente, impegno da parte nostra di tutta l'organizzazione. Questo è stato molto, giustamente, come capite, impegnativo, perché abbiamo dovuto fare lo startup che era previsto in 6 mesi, farlo in un solo mese. Questo obiettivo è stato raggiunto grazie anche alla scelta di trovarci in Tunisia, principalmente per i motivi che riguardano la competenza del personale già formato, la disponibilità di lavoratori con esperienza nel settore, la disponibilità di supporto da parte delle autorità locali per trovare personale qualificato in così breve tempo, e tutto ciò ha permesso di rispettare gli impegni con i clienti. Come si può evincere, in un mese abbiamo triplicato le ore prodotte, quindi post pandemia, insomma, è stato un impegno notevole che abbiamo avuto l'orgoglio e la soddisfazione di poter gestire e riuscire a ottenere. La nostra previsione è di arrivare nei prossimi 2 anni ad avere 700 dipendenti, sommati ai dipendenti presenti nel nostro terzista, porta una presenza complessiva in Tunisia di 1000 persone. La nostra esperienza e la nostra visione confermano che in Tunisia si può ancora investire con soddisfazione. Io vi ringrazio per l'attenzione e spero, fatto il più breve possibile, e mi scuso ancora per i problemi di connessione.
So, thank you, Mr. Faujana. Okay, now we end the second section with the final presentation and experience from Sparco. It is a peculiar Italian company because they are present in the OEM sector. That means they are a supplier of automotive manufacturers, but at the same time, they are historically active in the racing and karting sector, because they are a supplier of Swiss helmets, steering wheels, seats and belts, and other type of components. This company has a very historical presence in Tunisia, and now I leave the floor to Claudio Pastori, that is the managing director of the company, that he will explain us and share his experience.
Good morning, everybody. I thank all for the invitation to attend this meeting. I'll give my regards back to Anis Bentili. We work for many years in Parco some years ago. It is a pleasure that Sparco brings here is long-standing and consolidated experience referred to our activities in Tunisia. Sparco is an Italian company founded in Torino in 1977. During a period when FIA as you know, I imagine the Federation International dell'Automotive, in the dramatic period in the 70s, when the race were affected by fatal accident, FIA introduced the safety standards to safeguard drivers, and Sparco born in that period. Since then, our skill in motorsport grew constantly. We made safety and daily mission and reinforce our market leadership by broadening our product portfolio for technical sportswear in competition and safety accessory. Now our catalog is about 700 different products, decline in size and colors in more than 8,000 items. all Spark Racing products are homologated and approved by FIA and SFIA. SFIA is the same of SFIA in the United States, is the regulating body in the United States. Sparco Motorsport is a niche business. No? We lead the market with approximately an estimate of 30% of world market share worldwide. No? The export represents 80% of the total turnover, 50%, more than 50% is outside Europe, in the United States, Japan, Australia, and South America, mainly. I would like to, one moment. Okay.
This is a very synthetic presentation.
Sparco is not only racing and motorsport. We are active in other business since 2000. We entered OE business with seats and carbon fiber components for aerospace and automotive industries. We are supplying the main automotive top brand, such as Lamborghini, Ferrari, Alfa Romeo, Bugatti, Maserati, Ford, and other major brands. In the meantime, Sparco United States set in California and in Tunisia, always in the middle of the 90s, in Grombelia. We opened a plant to produce seats, racing seats, clothing, and more recently, shoes, seat belts, and since 2013, carbon parts. With such background in safety products, in 2017, entered in teamwork producing producing safety shoes. Also, to give you an idea where we are and some highlights. The turnover last year was 90 million euro. We have at the end of last year 1,100 employees, of which 550 in Tunisia. We have 1,000 retailers worldwide, and we sell our racing products in 100 countries worldwide. No, and the racing is and remain the main business. We keep more than 300 teams. They participate in the important international events. Oh, this is Sparco. Now we have introduced a second plant to produce carbon parts in Meghira, very close to Tunisia. No? And also, I would like to give you, to everybody, an overview of our industrial activities in Tunisia. As I said before, our operation in Tunisia that back to the middle of the 90s with the startup of a plant for the production of shoes and racing seats and other racing products. No? Since then and during the years, we started in the same area in Trombelia, the first plant to produce carbon parts. And after that, in the past year, carbon component business has steadily grown up, and we have the necessity to add a second plane that it was inaugurated at the beginning of May this month. No? Together we employed in Tunisia 550 people, but our forecast is to reach in the next month 700 workers. No? Together with the group we are an important growing mainly in the carbon. We are investing a lot in this Tunisian plane. No? Let me finish with a thought. 2050 years have gone, a quarter of century since we first opened our operation in Tunisia, and even been though different historical moments, many things are changed, but we, according to what the other people have already said, Tunisia is a geostrategic favorable position at the center of the Mediterranean area, up to date and efficient in land and international logistic network. Goods can be in Italy in 2 days, no, through 3 days. The administrative procedure for import and export are very simplified, and also is very easy to work now also with the in this country. Tunisia is playing a model role within North African and Middle Eastern areas, and is renewed social political stability and a dynamic and efficient economy. This is very important for us, no? And we, I think, we continue to our project to continue to invest in Tunisia, also in the next year, if this condition will continue, it also the market will continue to grow. No? Thank you for your attention.
So thank you, Mr. Pastori, for the case history of Sparco. Now we are a little out of time, but we enter into the Q&A session. We have two or three questions that are already present in the chat, and I try to merge two questions that are maybe could be addressed to Mr. Bucialla or Mr. Bentayli, that are regarding the presence or the perspectives regarding some components like the pillars, the headliners, and the non-woven tissue. So please, if you have some information, you can give us some inputs. Mr. Bentayli, have you some information regarding this request from Mr. De Pasquale? You have to turn your audio on. Can you hear me, Mr. Bentayli? Mr. Bucciara is already connected.
Yeah, I'm here. Yeah.
Okay. So you have some information related to pillars and liners, or in general for the interiors?
As you know, we have a mix of the plastic walls and we have plastic parts, and all the for sure headliners can be produced here in Tunisia. For the moment, I didn't see that they already produced it in some companies here, but we are able to produce in some companies related to the plastic and assembly parts, related to also electrical and cables, that something very easier to be produced here in Tunisia. I think it's something that has to be a connection with the company that they are producing for the moment. Some part of lighting the doors, lighting doors and things that can be added to the headline.
Okay, thank you for your reply. So the other question is for Mr. Gnami from FIPA, because one of the participants asked if there are other OEMs that are planning to be present in the near future in the country. So are you working with some of the car maker?
Yes, it's a good question. Well, the objective, we have a common objective, I think, with the Tunisia Automotive Association, and one of the mission which has been presented by Mr. Naben is to attract car producer in Tunisia. It is, well, the approach in Tunisia is quite different from our other competing countries. So we have been mainly focusing on the development of our supply chain. Our supply chain is well developed, and it's really one of the most assets of Tunisia. It wasn't in the past an objective to have a car producer in Tunisia for many reasons, maybe linked to the market, because we have a relatively small market compared even to our neighboring countries. But now it's time, I think, and we have been working in the last few years and we had serious contacts with several car producers from different parts, from Europe, from North America, and also from Asia. We are still optimistic, and we believe that there is an opportunity in Tunisia. But the priorities and the situation of the automotive industry globally is changing. So now there are new trends, and we are focusing mainly on electric cars. So we have some contacts already, and even some companies, international and Tunisian, are working on this field. So The priority is to enhance our competitiveness in the supply chain, but we have an objective to attract a car producer in the near future, and we are working together on a value proposition to convince a car producer to come, because we believe that the supply chain can be completed and can be there is an added value to have a car producer based in Tunisia.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Grammy, for your remarks. So I thank you also from Dino that is available in Tunisia for some of the potential investors, because they are open for a visit to their plant. And I think that we can close and end right now to the webinar. I would like, I confirm that we will send the presentation to the different mailing list. That means that FIPA and ANFIA will send the presentation to the respective members. Just a remark, a personal, I would like to thank from our side, from ANFIA, Sabrina Rosa, that she worked very hard on the organization of this event, and also for FIPA, Bilal Arduri, that was our partner in the organization of the event. And thank you to all the participants and to the speakers that gave a complete overview of the country in general and from the perspective of the automotive sector. I confirm that ANFIA or FIPA are available for future development. Okay, thank you to everyone.
Thank you very much. Thank you. To all the participants for ANFIA and TA.
Grazie, bravi. Viva l'Italia.
Arrivederci a tutti.
Arrivederci.
Thank you.
Per buongiorno.
Grazie. Thank you.
Ok, thank you. Everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, bye.
See you soon. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for everybody.
Everybody. Sitting up here.